In this video, I'll show you the steps I took to completely refurbish this gorgeous buffet. I just couldn't pass up this gorgeous piece with that stunning tiger oak wood grain on top and the solid wood, the details. The inside was a little bit rustic, if you ask me, with these strange support blocks that were all different sizes and didn't look uniform, but I knew it would be an easy fix. So the first thing I did was to give this thing a thorough cleaning. It was very dirty and had this sticky, gummy residue in all the edges and crevices. So I got out my metal scraper and scraped all that off. Also using a small little brush for the inside pieces. Next, I removed all those support blocks, and don't worry, I'm going to replace them with new ones because I know they're important for the support of the piece. I took off the back because it was falling apart, and I measured a piece of wood for a new back, cut it, and stained it using one of my favorite shades, Kona, in a gel stain. Since the inside of the piece was a little bit damaged and scraped up, I knew that I wanted a dark stain to hide that damage. So the next thing I did was cut two shelves for the inside of the piece using my circular saw. And I stained those in the Kona gel stain as well. And then I moved on to sanding. I sanded the entire piece. It was pretty beat up and it needed a thorough stripping. I sanded everything, including the inside of the drawers, the inside of the cabinet, the legs, and the top, completely down to bare wood. The only thing I did not sand was the trim. So first I used an 80 grit sanding net, and then I used a 120 grit, and finally a 220 grit. The next thing I did was to cut new support blocks. Normally, you would measure and cut these all a uniform size, but the wood on this piece is slightly warped, and so each piece needed to be cut a custom size. I stained these in the Kona gel stain as well, and let them dry. Next, I installed these support blocks with some wood glue, and you'll see that I'm just using this board, which is just to clamp them in. So now I left the back off so that I could easily stain the inside, and I'm staining the entire inside of the cabinet, top, bottom, and sides. I used a pointed small paintbrush to get in the crevices and cracks, since the foam pad doesn't do that as well. And I just really covered the inside of that piece as good as I could with this thick gel stain so that no imperfections will show through. I did the entire inside of the drawers as well, and also the inside of the cabinet doors. Once that was finished, it was time to work on the outside. So I started with a whitewashing, which I thought would be really cool on this piece, but it actually kind of hid the wood grain, which for a tiger oak piece, I did not want to do that. I really wanted to accentuate the wood grain. So after I got the whitewash on, I decided to do a wipe on neutral stain on top. And that I thought looked really pretty. The only problem I had with that was that it dried so fast. So some of the areas were a little bit blotchy and I wasn't really happy with that. So once it was completely dry, I actually sanded it with a 220 grit sandpaper, and look how beautiful that looks. You can see that I'm just sanding off kind of the blotchy, darker, streaky part, and then it's a smooth, uniform, neutral look with the wood grain showing through. After I finished sanding, I sealed the entire piece with black wax, using a wax brush all over the entire piece. And then I buffed everything with a soft t-shirt cloth. Next, I carefully installed the back since I was done with the inside of the cabinets. And then I placed the shelves on top of the supports. For the hardware, I used one of my all-time favorites, Dawn dish soap, and just scrubbed with a small little brush to clean it up. And then I used some steel wool to remove the remaining grime and shine it up a little bit until it was that pretty copper look that you see. And here's the results. If you're interested in purchasing this piece, please visit renewedbychloe.com and click shop.